If you take a glass slab, it is basically what? A cubical shaped glass piece. You wanted to study how refraction takes place through it. We can consider an activity. What we'll do is, we'll place a glass slab on a piece of paper, white paper, which is fixed to a drawing board, and then trace its boundaries. So ABCD, like here shown, ABCD is the boundary of the glass slab. Then what we'll do is, we'll take some point on AB side of the glass slab, which is marked over there, and then select one particular convenient point, say Q. At that particular point, what we'll do is, we'll draw a normal, making NN dash, marking it as NN dash, there is a normal at the point Q. Then what we'll do is, we'll take a convenient angle and then draw a line PQ. So this PQ line can be considered as the incident ray on the side AB of the glass slab. So we should be able to know that particular angle, whatever the angle between PQ and normal NN dash is there. So this angle marked as I1 can be considered as the angle of incidence on the face AB of the glass slab. Now what we'll do, we'll fix two pins at the points E and F. See that the foot of the pins are aligned along the same line. We should also see that the two pins are vertically straight. Okay, they are perpendicular to the plane of the paper, and we'll fix two pins at the points E and F. So considerably maintaining some distance of say 5 to 10 centimeters between the points E and F, we'll fix two pins. Now we'll place this glass slab on the its boundaries ABCD. After placing that, what we'll do is, we will see the two pins which are kept at the points E and F from CD part of the glass slab, and then we will place two more pins, say G and H, at a distance, maintaining some distance, such that whatever we see those two pins E and F and this G and H, all these four pins should be appearing to be in the same straight line when you see from the side CD of the glass slab. Once I mark these two pins G and H, I'll mark those two points over there, then take away the pins completely, take away the glass slab also. Then what I'll do, I'll just join these two points G and H and produce it to meet the surface CD at the point R. So now R and S, on which this line, this G and H pins are marked, this line will represent the light ray which has emerged out of the glass slab. Now if you see the points R and the point Q, they are not in a same straight line. If you produce the line PQ, extend it up to, we'll get the points like LT. So actually the light ray should travel along the direction PQLT. That should be the direction of the light ray. But what is happening? The light ray is bending in the glass slab along the line Q to R. Q is the point of incidence on the AB side, and R is the point of emergence of the light ray on the surface CD of the glass slab. We say it as emergence. Why? Because it is coming out of the glass slab. So there are two interfaces over here. One is AB, wherein the light ray is entering glass from air. Other interface is CD, where the light ray is coming out of the glass and entering into air. Now at this point R, I will drop a normal perpendicular to the surface CD, mark it as mm dash. Now this mm dash will be the normal at the point R on the surface CD of the glass slab. Now if I mark some angles, I1 is the angle of incidence on the face AB at the point Q. The angle between NN dash and QR will be marked as R1, the angle of refraction inside the glass slab. Now this QR is representing the reflected ray. At the point R, the light ray is passing through the glass slab and incident on the surface CD of the glass air interface. So there, if I mark the angle between M dash M and QR, so basically it is the angle QR M dash, that can be marked as angle R2. This R2 is the angle of incidence inside the glass. And now finally the angle which is between MR and S, MRS, this angle will be marked as I2. I can call it as angle of emergence. If you see carefully, this I1 and I2 values will be equal, and whatever the line I produce making PQ along L and T, so PQLT line will be parallel to this RS line. RS is what? The emergent ray. So in fact, if you see, after refraction through this glass slab, where its surfaces AB and CD are parallel to each other, what I am observing is the light ray, which should follow along the path PQLT, is getting shifted laterally by some distance, and it is following the different path. Direction is the same. There is no change in the direction because the line RS is parallel to PQLT. So it is the same direction. But what is happening? It is shifting by some distance. And this is what you call lateral shift. How much is the shift? If you wanted to know it, what we'll do is we'll drop a normal from the point R onto the line PQLT. So where L is the foot of the perpendicular from the point R. In such a case, then this RL length will show me the lateral shift of the light ray because of the refraction through the glass slab. So in the glass slab, basically the light ray is incident into the glass slab. It is deviating towards the normal, and at the other end where it is coming out of the glass slab, it is emerging out. So there the angle of emergence is greater than the angle of incidence. Okay, because it is going from optically denser medium to optically rarer medium. Because the medium is air on either sides of the glass slab, for that reason we have the angle of incidence is equal to the angle of emergence. You can apply the refractive index formula over there. So if I apply refractive index over the surface AB, then I will be able to get the refractive index of the glass slab as sin I1 by sin R1. If I apply the same expression at the CD point, CD interface, I will get the refractive index of the glass slab as sin of I2 divided by sin of R2. Because R1 and R2 both are equal, because they are alternate angles to the two parallel sides. Two parallel sides are NN dash and MM dash. For these two parallel sides, this RS, which is the refracted ray, is acting like a transversal. So this R1 and R2 are the angles which are on either sides of the alternate angles. They form the alternate pair, interior alternate pair. So they are equal. So when R1 and R2 both are equal, in the expressions for sin I1 by sin R1 and sin I2 by sin R2, when R1 is equal to R2, we will have sin R1 is equal to sin R2. Because it is sin R1 is equal to sin R2, then we will have sin I1 is equal to sin I2. So we have I1 is equal to I2. So this is the concept involved in refraction of light through a rectangular glass slab. Hope this is clear to you.